In other news, several bills seeking to ban industrially produced trans fatty acids have been refiled in Congress. For more on this and the importance of such a measure, we are joined by Dr. Luigi Pierre Segundo, the director of the Philippine Heart Association, as well as attorney Maria Ann Rosales. She's the project manager of Imagine Law's Healthy Diets Program. Good morning, Dr. Attorney. Thank you for joining
us. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. Dr. Segundo, first off, what exactly is trans fat? Why do we see it in so many of our food supply?
Trans fat, or to be more specific, the industrially processed trans fat, is partially hydrogenated fat. These are usually from vegetable oils, but to make them more stable, they're partially hydrogenated. This does not have any health benefits, and they're actually shown to contribute to the top causes of deaths in the Philippines.
Let's go to you, Attorney Rosales. Your group Imagine Law actually welcomes this the proposed bills, right, on trans fatty acids. But what are the current DOH and FDA rules on this? Why is there a need for a law on this?
Right. So in 2011, the Department of Health issued a policy on prevention and control of non-communicable diseases, but it was not enough to regulate trans fatty acids. So in 2019, the Department of Health and the FDA actually issued regulations removing trans fat, or mandating food manufacturers to remove trans fat from pre-packaged and processed food. However, this does not cover all sources of industrially produced trans fat. That's why we need legislation so that ITSA sources, or industrially trans fat sources, in food establishments as well as in traditional markets, are also regulated.
And Dr. Luigi, what exactly are the harmful effects that trans fatty acids actually pose to our bodies?
Yeah, what we know more about are the cholesterols, right? The bad cholesterol, which is LDL, low density lipoprotein, and the good cholesterol, which is high density lipoprotein. LDL is actually what contributes to deposition of plaques in our arteries. We call that atherosclerosis. So arteries are the blood vessels that supply oxygen and blood to the heart and the brain. And trans fat, consumption of large amounts of trans fat actually increases your bad cholesterol and decreases your good cholesterol. Thus, it can promote to more deaths by heart attacks and stroke.
So we got to take care of our hearts, one way or another. And Attorney Maria Ann, what has been hindering such bills from passing in previous Congresses?
Right. So, Nikki, it's always, there's always competing interests when pushing for public health. But in the last Congress, the trans fat bills actually advanced very well. It was filed in the second year of Congress, and it was also approved already at the committee level in both houses. It was just that it was COVID, and it was very hard, to always compete with all of these emerging situations that had to be addressed. And so we're very, very hopeful in this Congress, in the 19th Congress, just within the first week, many bills has already been filed. And right now we have, I think, three bills in the Senate and three bills also in the House of Representatives. So we're very hopeful that it's being prioritized.
And then Dr. Segundo, is it actually possible to remove trans fat altogether? I mean, the bills also mandate that they be reformulated. Is this possible?
Well, trans fat, at least the industrial, it's artificially produced. So it's possible to remove.
What's a good alternative?
Oh, well, it's a polyunsaturated fats, mostly from olive oil and canola, from nuts and fish. Those are the healthy sources of fat.
And is there a good alternative to this? How do we reformulate it in a way that food could still be preserved without the use of trans fat?
Well, again, the use of naturally occurring healthy oils, olive oil, canola, and I'm sure there will be healthier alternatives if our industries choose to study for those.
And attorney, how optimistic are you then that this time the bills would be signed into law, you know, looking at our COVID situation?
Yes, we're very optimistic, you know, that this will form the plan of the administration to build back better. Because really, if we are to build back better and to recover from COVID-19, we need to invest in people's health. We need to invest in our heart health so that our citizens are better equipped to face any pandemic, any endemic that may come our way. But we all need, you know, to still band together, make noise, and make sure that it's always at the top of the agenda.
Mm-hmm. And Dr. Segundo, anything to add from the perspective, of course, of a health professional, also on the current FDA and DOH rules that we currently have in place?
Yeah, we're seeing younger patients having heart attacks early. Before, we thought it was just the 50 years old and above. And now we're seeing patients who seem to be healthy before or actually in their 30s. Having a premature heart attacks and stroke. We believe it's related to the intake of trans fat. And so we welcome this bill in promoting healthy hearts for the Filipinos.
All right, short but sweet. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Dr. Segundo, Attorney Rosales, you both stay safe.
Thank you.
Thank you.